Hi everyone and welcome to a new video. This time I'll be doing a full teardown of the HP EliteDesk 800 G1 SFF. During the reassembly, I'll also be doing some upgrades like replacing the hard disk, installing an SSD and upgrading the memory. Earlier I did a very similar video on the newer version of the system, the G3, so feel free to check this out. Also, if you like this type of content, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel for more of the same. Let's start by having a look at the system before we disassemble it.
At the front of the PC, we can find a slim DVD drive, the power button, 3.5-inch slot, 2x USB 2, 2x USB 3, and front audio. At the back, we have two PS2 ports, network, USB, two display ports, serial, VGA, more USB 2 and USB 3 ports, audio, and finally the power connector. To open the case, we can lift the lever and remove the top panel. Inside, we can see the power supply, CPU and cooler. Here we have the PCIe slots, the memory, hard disk and a DVD drive. It's possible to lift the drive cage for better access to the motherboard. Time to start our teardown. Let's keep it simple and start by removing this plastic cover to guide the airflow. Next, I will disconnect the DVD drive, and in order to remove it, we need to remove the front cover first. Then we can hold the green lever and slide the DVD drive out front. After that, we can disconnect the hard disk and disconnect the SATA cables. The hard disk slides out as well. Now I will remove the remaining connectors from the motherboard. Front panel connectors, power, front USB and audio. Last one to disconnect is the CPU pin. Now that everything is disconnected, I can remove the motherboard from the case. Seems I forgot about the speaker, so let me take care of that first. And in order to remove the motherboard, we also will need to remove the CPU cooler, as it's screwed down to the chassis as well. To make some space, I will first get the memory out, which is a single 4GB module at this time. Now we are good to remove the CPU cooler. And we get a first glimpse of the CPU. Now I can remove the motherboard from the case. Here's the motherboard after I removed it from the case. Let's get that CPU cleaned up by removing the old thermal paste. And of course, the same needs to happen with the CPU cooler. Time to have a better look at this motherboard. Here's the CPU socket, the 4 DDR3 memory slots with 2 channels and 2 slots per channel, PCIe X16, 2x X1, and an X16 downgraded to X4. the BIOS chip, front panel connectors like audio, USB and a speaker. Here we can see the proprietary power connectors and more front panel connections for the LEDs and USB. There is also an additional header for a serial port and a parallel port, the SATA ports, P4 connector, and finally the CPU fan power. Let's continue by removing the CPU from the socket, which is the last part. As you can see, the machine I have is equipped with an i5-4570. Here we have all the parts lined up nicely. A replacement hard disk of 1TB, an SSD, the CPU, 2x4GB of memory, the DVD drive, CPU cooler, and of course, the motherboard. Time to reassemble everything. I will start with the memory. As told, there are 4 slots, 2 per channel, where the black ones need to be populated first for best performance. As we only have 2 modules, that's what we will populate. The CPU is up next and can just be put in the socket as long as the orientation is correct. Then we can close the socket. That's more or less all we can do outside the case, as the CPU fan needs to get fixed to the chassis. So let's get the motherboard back in there. Some fresh thermal paste. And then we can put back the CPU cooler. And of course, we shouldn't forget to connect it. Now the rest of the connections to the motherboard, starting with power, and the connections for the front panel, USB, the power button and LEDs. Audio, speaker, and more audio. For the drives, these are held by these special screws that hold them in the drive cage. So we will need to move these to the new hard disk. For the SSD, although I have additional screws, the thread is different, so I will need to find another solution to fix the SSD. Before we install the drives, let's first put the SATA cables back in place. And then the power, which runs through the motherboard. As we install those screws on our hard disk, it just clicks in place in the cage and we can connect to power and data. The DVD drive goes in from the front and gets connected to power and SATA as well. Last one to install is the SSD. Which I will just keep dangling here for now until I get my hands on a bracket. Not the most pretty solution, but as there is no moving parts in it, this shouldn't cause any problem. Final parts are the plastic fan duct, the front panel, and of course the lid to close the case completely. Time for the test. We already got something on the screen, which is already a good sign, and we do get a memory size error, but this is expected as we upgraded to 8 GB. I pressed the key to enter the BIOS, so let's have a look here at the system info. We can see our i5-4570 and the 2x4 GB for a total of 8 GB of memory. For the drive, we can see as well that everything is detected, the SSD, 1 TB hard disk and DVD drive. So it looks like everything went just fine and we are ready to boot to the OS. Unfortunately, the footage where I did that seemed to have gone missing, but all was working fine.
Thanks a lot for watching. I really hope you liked the video, and if you did, please put a thumbs up. If you like this or similar content, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel for more of the same. Thanks again, and I really hope to see you back here soon.